Oxygen level critical.
In a groundbreaking revelation, leading astrobiologists posit that the Viking landers might have stumbled upon evidence of microbial life on Mars half a century ago. Yet, the very experiments designed to unearth this life could have unintentionally obliterated it.
So we know that Mars was geologically active. It had active geochemistry. We also know that it was wet at some point in the past. Certainly, 3.8 billion years ago, the same time that life was getting a foothold here on Earth, the conditions on Mars were very similar. In fact, even rather more benign, we think. So Mars is a planet that shared the same conditions as Earth when life began on Earth. So that may suggest that we might expect to find that life had begun on Mars. That's something we can test, and we are trying to test now. So we're looking for the evidence that life did exist on Mars, or perhaps evidence that it still exists, because we again have strong evidence that the water on Mars did not all escape to space. So it is not beyond the realms of possibility at all that there are Martians today, or that there were Martians in the past.
Mars, a desolate and arid world, could harbor unique microbes tailored to its dry conditions. These fascinating organisms might possess hydrogen peroxide, allowing them to harness water from the Martian atmosphere. The Viking missions conducted several experiments to detect potential life on the Red Planet. One such experiment involved introducing water to Martian soil samples. This was based on the premise that life on Mars, akin to Earth, would necessitate water. However, this could have been a fatal error, as inundating these drought-resistant microbes might have annihilated them. Another experiment that involved heating the soil samples might have combusted any organic compounds, particularly if these Martian organisms had hydrogen peroxide in their cellular makeup. The profound irony lies in the fact that our methods to detect Martian life might have been the very reason we came up empty-handed. Such a revelation prompts a pivotal question. If we did discover life on Mars, but failed to identify it, how does this influence our strategy when seeking life on distant exoplanets?
It's one of the great questions. We mean civilizations. If we find life on Mars, it'll be microbes. And it's a tremendously important question, I think. How far would you have to go? There must be other civilizations somewhere in the universe. There are 400 billion suns in our galaxy, and there are 2 trillion galaxies in the observable universe. So clearly, there has to be someone. The question is, how far? And actually, when I speak to biologists, it's interesting. If you look at the history of life on Earth, there's an unbroken chain of life. We're all related to every living thing on the planet. The origin of life is nearly 4 billion years ago on this planet. But it took most of that time to put a civilization on the planet. 4 billion years, a third of the age of the universe. And so it's possible to argue that there may be very few civilizations out there in a typical galaxy. Often, I'd say a good working assumption is there's one, which is us.
Unearthing life on Mars, especially of a kind alien to our understanding, would radically alter our methods of searching for life on exoplanets. It would broaden our perspectives, compel us to question our preconceived notions, and foster innovation in the realms of astrobiology and space exploration. In a related development, NASA scientists have unveiled the potential existence of a vast water ocean on an exoplanet named K2-18b, situated roughly 120 light-years away in the Leo constellation. This revelation was made feasible by the James Webb Space Telescope. K2-18b, with a mass nearly 9 times that of Earth, is classified as a Haishan exoplanet. This suggests it may possess a hydrogen-dense atmosphere atop a surface blanketed by oceans. The planet's atmospheric composition hints at a water-dominated world. Intriguingly, there's a suggestion of dimethyl sulfide, a molecule that, on our planet, is exclusively biogenic. Consider the myriad planets that circle stars far beyond our reach. Worlds like K2-18b, with expansive oceans shielded by hydrogen-laden atmospheres, might be brimming with life forms, ranging from rudimentary microbes to intricate beings, each evolved to thrive in their distinct habitats. Yet if the cosmos is bustling with life, possibly with societies far more ancient and sophisticated than ours, Why haven't we perceived any evidence of their existence? This brings us to the Fermi paradox, a long-standing question that ponders the apparent contradiction between the high probability of extraterrestrial civilizations and humanity's lack of contact with or evidence for such civilizations.
If civilizations are common, or even slightly common, then there should be civilizations ahead of us, because there's been so much time. You imagine the timescales. We've been around, say, 40,000 years. The galaxy is pretty much as old as the universe. It's 13 billion years worth of time. So the idea that there are civilizations arose, you know, 100 million years ago, 200 million years ago, 1 billion years ago. And imagine what they'd be like if they'd survived. We've had science for, let's say, since Newton or Copernicus, 500 years at most. And look what we've done. We've gone beyond the solar system with Voyager. We've walked on the moon. We're about to go to Mars, I would think. So we're about to begin colonizing our own solar system. So we've done that in 500 years. It's one of the arguments often used to say there aren't any civilizations out there in the galaxy. It's called the Fermi paradox. Because if you imagine a civilization that's a million years ahead of us, they should have written their presence across the sky by now. You should see them. If we survive a million years into the future, actually even a few thousand years into the future, we will be exploring the galaxy. We will have spacecraft that are going to other stars. We will be doing it. So our signature will become visible, I'm sure, if we last.
The quest for intelligent life is now pivoting towards detecting technosignatures. Technosignatures refer to signs or markers of advanced technology on distant planets. These could range from atmospheric pollutants, indicative of industrial activity, to large-scale energy harnessing structures, like the hypothetical Dyson spheres. The discovery of technosignatures would be monumental. It would not only confirm the existence of advanced civilizations, but also reshape our understanding of the universe. Realizing that we are not the sole bearers of advanced technology would challenge our perceived uniqueness and centrality in the cosmos. Such a revelation would also invigorate our space exploration endeavors, pushing us to develop technologies to reach out, understand, or even collaborate with these distant civilizations. The crowning glory would be to identify markers of a technologically advanced civilization.
In the future, they have plans for missions that are going to directly image exoplanets, potentially Earth-like planets. And I'm willing to bet that by the end of this century, if there is life on a planet 50 to 100 light years away, we're going to have found it. So once we find it, then we can study it. We can learn more about it. If it's intelligent life, is it warlike? Are they like us? What kind of technology do they have? What are they like? We can eavesdrop on their own leakage and learn more about them. And then once we do know more about them, then we can think about making contact. To me, that would be the responsible thing to do. That would be what I would expect an advanced civilization to do with us, and to treat us with kid gloves, rather than come blurting in. The stars are like a mirror. We look to the stars for alien life, but we see our faces reflected back. When we consider advanced alien civilizations, they're a proxy for advanced human civilizations. And we have a chance to perhaps one day be one of those advanced civilizations, but we won't be if we blow ourselves up, or a million other threats that we face. So we could start right now addressing these concerns and building a better future. And perhaps one day we will be one of those advanced civilizations, and we will be able to reach out into the galaxy and meet other civilizations.
The discovery of signs of technology from extraterrestrial civilizations would rank among the most profound and transformative discoveries in human history. However, Brian Cox has suggested that Earth might be, metaphorically speaking, the only island of meaning in a galaxy of 400 billion suns, which would make our existence and the meaning we derive from it even more special and awe-inspiring.
We should operate such that we are it in this galaxy. There's nothing else. I'm sure there are other civilizations out there in the universe, because there are 2 trillion galaxies. I just can't believe this hasn't happened in other places. The question is, how often does it happen, and how widely spaced are the civilizations? And I think they're very widely spaced, and I think there may be 1 or 2 per galaxy on the average.
The vastness of the universe coupled with our ever-evolving understanding of life and technology, suggests that our search for extraterrestrial life is just beginning.